Welcome. In this film, we will explain some basic terms to help you understand key information about the climate in the old and new towns of Edinburgh UNESCO World Heritage Site and what changes we can expect to see in the future. There are three sections to this film: current climate, recent past, and future trends. We'll come back to them later. Firstly, it's important to understand that weather and climate are not quite the same. The main difference is that they refer to different timescales. Weather describes the short-term conditions of the atmosphere, usually over hourly or daily periods, and often measures things like temperature, rainfall, cloudiness, and sunshine. Climate, on the other hand, is the average of these conditions over longer time periods, ranging from years to decades. In Scotland, we have what's called a temperate maritime climate. This means that the changes between our seasons are quite subtle in comparison to other areas of the world. We do experience unpredictable and changeable weather, but rarely the very extreme weather we see elsewhere around the world. Our day-to-day weather is very changeable due to our location on the edge of the Northern Atlantic, as well as our proximity to continental Europe. This means that our day-to-day weather is influenced by lots of different air masses. For example, the Arctic maritime air mass from the north, which brings wet and cold air and snow in winter. Weather systems originating from the southwest of the country are what we experience most often. Edinburgh is slightly warmer than both the Scotland and UK average, with an annual average temperature of just over 9 degrees Celsius. The coolest month on average tends to be December, and the warmest July. Air frost is when the air temperature is below the freezing point of water that sits at a height of at least 1 meter above the ground. The city of Edinburgh experiences around 46 days of air frost on average each year, fewer than both the Scotland and UK averages. With just over 700 millimeters of rainfall recorded on average each year, Edinburgh is considerably drier than other parts of Scotland, with around half as much rainfall as the Scotland average. There are, on average, 124 days a year with rain totals of over 1 millimetre in Edinburgh, compared to 170 days in Glasgow. Rainfall is generally well distributed throughout the year in Edinburgh, though the driest month tends to be April and the wettest October. Eastern Scotland is one of the windier parts of the UK. Wind speed and gusts are high, especially from December to February. Let's move on to look at the recent past. Changes to our climate are influenced by the levels of greenhouse gas emissions in our atmosphere. Recently, increasing levels of greenhouse gas emissions have resulted in accelerated and more extreme changes to our climate. Over the last few decades, Scotland has experienced a warming trend, shifting rainfall patterns, and rising sea levels. Annual average temperatures have risen by 0.9 degrees Celsius compared to 1961 to 1990 averages. Over the last decade, summers have been 13% wetter and winters 12% wetter compared to 1961 to 1990 averages. There are no compelling trends in storminess, as determined by maximum gust speeds from the UK wind network, over the last four decades. Mean sea level around the UK has risen by approximately 1.4 millimetres per year from the start of the 20th century, and rates of erosion on Scotland's soft coastline have near doubled since the 1970s. Scotland's five warmest years on record have all occurred since 2003, with 2014 being the hottest on record. You can see the warming trend clearly in the climate stripes diagram that tracks the average temperature for each year from the late 1800s. There has been an increase in rainfall over Scotland in the past few decades, with an increasing proportion of rainfall coming from heavy rainfall events. The wettest days in the east of Scotland are now 32% wetter than earlier in the 20th century. Finally, let's look at what we can expect in the future. Edinburgh, like the rest of Scotland, we'll continue to see changes in our climate in the decades ahead. The extent to which Edinburgh's climate will change will be controlled by the actions taken, or not taken, to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. If global levels of greenhouse gas emissions continue to rise, then we will experience greater, more extreme changes in the climate, compared to a future where levels of greenhouse gases are significantly reduced. When looking at what future changes in the climate could be, scientists have developed different scenarios that calculate how different levels of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere could affect our climate. The 2018 UK climate projections produced by the Met Office Hadley Centre provide up-to-date information about the potential future climate in Scotland. The projections provide a range of potential climate outcomes based on a set of four pathways for greenhouse gas emissions: a low emissions scenario, two medium emissions scenarios, and a high emissions scenario. Across all future scenarios, and certainly up until the middle of the 21st century, there are some generally agreed trends that describe how our climate will change. Let's look at them now. Average temperatures will increase across all seasons. The extent of this increase will depend on the future scenarios and associated levels of greenhouse gases. For Edinburgh, like for the rest of the country, if these levels of greenhouse gases are high, the increase will be steeper than if they are low. 2018 was a hot year in the UK. The chance of exceeding such hot summers or heat waves is low. However, by 2050, the chance of hot summers could be as high as 50%. Summer rainfall is projected to decrease, although extreme downpours will be heavier despite the overall drying trend. Winters are projected to become wetter in terms of both the total amount of rainfall and the number of wet days. The increase is expected to be larger in western Scotland compared to the east. The intensity of rainfall on the wettest days is also expected to increase. Regarding climate projections, there is no identified trend in the wind speed over the UK. It is believed that current values will remain the same in the future. Humidity, or more precisely relative humidity, is the concentration of water vapour in the air. Air with high relative humidity is very uncomfortable, as it affects our ability to cool our bodies in summer. A given temperature will feel higher to our body if the relative humidity is high. Projections indicate that relative humidity will increase significantly in the future, irrelevant of the future scenario and associated levels of greenhouse gases. Sea level rise for Edinburgh will range from 8 cm to 49 cm in a low emissions scenario and 30 cm to 90 cm in a high emissions scenario. In summary, and according to climate projections applicable to Scotland and Edinburgh, we can anticipate that weather will remain variable and may become more variable. Average temperatures will increase across all seasons. Typical summers will be warmer and drier. Typical winters will be milder and wetter. Intense, heavy rainfall events will increase in both winter and summer. Relative humidity will increase steadily over the coming years. Sea levels will rise. And there will be reduced frost and snowfall. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit www.ewh.org.uk.